Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I have completed my book on first Gnostic principles of one God, one faith, and I wanted to put it as e-book so that it could be put on Amazon and other, and the revenue earned, a royalty earned on that one, could be plowed back to print the paper version and other things. So whatever we get from this one, we put it back, not in my pocket. Remember, there was one apostle called Adai. He went to King Abgar in Iraq area, and he cured them, did all preaching, all he did, and when he wanted to depart, the king wanted to give him gifts. He refused to accept it. He said, "We have given our own to the people, and why should we accept gift from you?" So this is the beauty of devotion. That is why the people who first joined the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, they sold their properties and they formed a communal life. And when they used to go to the Jerusalem to work, they never asked money. They worked, they did the job. And if the person wants to pay, well and good. If he doesn't, they were too happy because they were preaching gospel. So freely we receive, freely we give, and they were totally cut off from mammon. And that is the beauty. That is same as in wilderness. And then they learned His word with devotion, and not that you go to church like the social club and then come out and off you go. That is not the way. We are approaching the end of the world, and what is happening in the Middle East is all written in the Bible. Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30, the parable wheat and tear. Their tears are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. The Jewish people, they are a nation of priests, and we should appreciate their sacrifices and all that the lesson they are teaching to people. Now, a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. When you become Jew outwardly, then you say bye-bye to your tribal father. This is the tribal self. When you give bye-bye to tribal father, then you become super bastard, which is called tears. And they become fanatic, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, outwardly. They become fanatic. They are all spiritual self, inwardly. Quality, not quantity. So they will be all destroyed all over the world. So the sectarian riots, the fanatic will kill and burn each other. So here is my message. Happy New Year 2016, the year when the Jews are supposed to be running for Israel. Now there is going to be the same pattern as used to be in 64 AD. Remember, in 62 AD they killed James the Just. And when they killed him, you know, there were nobody left who could defend them. They were all crook like Sodom and Gomorrah type people. So all the honest people and good people from Jerusalem, they left for Mount Pereira. So whatever left in Jerusalem was crooks of Sodom and Gomorrah. So then when they went to the villages outside Jerusalem, And they told them how bad they are, you know. The people start killing Jews. And when they will start killing, then in 64 AD, they start moving into Jerusalem for protection 2 years before the siege. Same way, it's going to be 2 years to 2018, which is going to be 70 years old. Israel protection up to 70 years old. After that, you will see how the opinion builds up against them. Nobody would like them. And then, you know, the destruction or the siege will start. And it will be 5 years before the atomic war. That means 2023 could be the atomic war. But God knows better. Because I'm a man, you know. I have a spirit which is erring. If I had the very Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit with capital S, I could have given the exact time. Never mind. We should work with good spirit, Holy Spirit, not thinking evil. Jesus has told us all that we need to know. But the predestined will decipher his gospel hidden under the parables. Parables are understood through logical reasoning that the once-born are incapable of doing. Once-born can understand the dead letters only, dead letters of the scripture. Remember, Jesus forbade, don't take any script with you. That means this Bible they are putting in the hand of Jesus and his icon, this is Antichrist. So, that is why gospel is for the twice-born sensible people and Holy Spirit, the spirit of man, is common sense. That is our companion. It is a gift of our Father that people could misuse to fleece people for mammon. They can misuse it, you know, like Judas Iscariot. He had the spirit, but he misused it for money and popularity. Psychic, or the pneumatic, Thomas, he went for God. Doubting, you know, he went for God. Then God sealed to serve God. Most people do this and become Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing, such as the hireling dog-collared priest in churches, satanic organization that ask for donations, but the people working for them get paid. So when you get paid, you know, there are many organizations running like donation for this thing, donation that thing. You donate their salaries, eat those donations away. They are like Judas Iscariot. In God, when you work free. If you get paid, then God is not stupid. He won't give you gospel treasures. So you can either have gospel treasures or mammon. It's your choice. Remember how the people sold their properties to enter the Church of God community headed by Christ Jesus. And Peter, the gatekeeper, killed two rotten eggs, Ananias and Saphira, for telling lies, which is building the temple of God on sand. Christ lives in a temple built on rock of truth. Remember when Jesus was there with talking with Samaritan woman? Then he told her, you don't need to worship on this mountain or that mountain, because this is the temple of God. God is inside you, Emmanuel. And you worship him in truth and in spirit. And then apostle used to visit such churches of truthful people to sow the seed of his word, urging people to worship God in spirit by preaching gospel called the drinking the blood of Christ Jesus. Remember Jesus, when he feed 5,000, he said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Eating the flesh is of Jesus, mean what came out of the mouth of Jesus You should hear it with your ear. This is the mouth, spiritual mouth. Take it to your heart, which is the seat of Christ. Over there, with your inner man, the Christ, you ponder over it. Yourself, as the born blind person in John 9 did, answer everything from his own heart. He didn't ask his parent what he should say. So ponder over it and then bring it from your own mouth in honor of Christ Jesus. That is called drinking the blood of Christ. So unless you do that, you have no part in him. So gospel is written over here, not in that dead letters of the book, which you can change. These Jewish people have corrupted the Old Testament. They have corrupted the new one also. There is no Lord in the royal kingdom of God and no disciples of Jesus. The word disciple is from discipline. You discipline a natural man once born. Jesus, only the twice born people will understand what he is preaching. Jesus was a preacher, not a teacher. Many of these university professors, they don't know the difference between teaching and preaching. These university professors, they are super donkeys carrying holy books. And you can pull their legs as you like it, because you have the spirit. You are not drunk with the old wine. So you can use common sense. I've written all this book based upon common sense. No reference to any book or any old Gnostic or this and that. What I know, then I can tell you what I've written. So gospel is in your heart, not in your head. Gospel is very simple to understand. If you long for it, you need to have an expressed desire, you know. This is how I have learned through intuition based upon logical reasoning. This I am going to explain in my book, written through the help of companion Holy Spirit by the grace of our Father. Our my Father is inside me. Me and my Father is in one. Because this is the temple of God, God lives inside, not outside the temple. So he is within you. So you have to worship him in truth and in spirit. But many people, you know, they don't do it. So if you find any grammatical mistake or any, you know, suggestion you want to make, please put your correction in a bracket in red so that I can understand it before rectifying my text. Please do not alter or delete my text, because I had an American who wanted to help me. He was genuine, you know. He did about 3-4 chapters. You can see under the chapter he put a symbol. Then I told him, my brother, don't please alter the text. You know, I have to go through again and again, you know, to see what's happening. Then he got upset, you know, because he wanted to put his own ideas also. I told him not to do it. If you want to put your own idea, all these what I have written, I have no copyright. So you can take this whole text and alter it as you like it, and put your own name so that you can explain what you have written. So this is the idea, you know, no copyright on my material. I want to put up an e-book, and your help would be much appreciated. I'm not good at IT, you know, so if anybody can help me, it will be appreciated. Some have come forward, but almost all have left me. There was a man in India too, you know, who was, hey, I will publish. When you finish, I will get 200 copies printed. And all went into the thin air. We will also have the normal printed book version later on, when we get money, you know, and everything, and support, technical support, we will then put them as soon as possible. I have no intention of taking money out of this project. In honor of Christ Jesus and Sadhguru Nanak Dev Ji, he was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469. And our intention is to glorify our Father, whose seed of Holy Spirit was planted by Him in our heart. So He planted, our Father planted, so we must glorify Him for giving us this Spirit by grace, so we can then perceive His word delivered by Christ Jesus and Sadhguru Nanak Dev Ji. So this link contains the whole book in a rugged format, and I hope someone will take interest to sort it up. As we are sons of man through Yahweh, called Brahma, Khuda, so we want to be the sons of the Most High Father God, called Allah in Arabic, Parbrahm, and Elohim. You know the word Allah, they know these Mohammedans know it stands for Son, but they don't know the origin of the word Allah. They know it, but they don't want to tell you. The origin of the word Allah is from Illah. Illah is the tribal father. That in Kaaba they used 360 Illah, representing their tribal fathers. But our Father God, which is supernatural, this is natural father, and the one in the soul, the father of the soul is supernatural, that is called Al-Illah. Al-Illah means Allah, in short. So, that's the origin of Allah. Awwal Allah Nurapaya, He is a Nur. Nur means He is not flesh, He is spirit. And spirit doesn't come under moral laws. Only flesh come under moral law. Spirit come under blasphemy or hypocrisy, which originate from your heart. So in Jesus or in God, we cannot commit sin, but blasphemy. In honor of our anointed elder brethren, Christ Jesus and Sadhguru Nanak Dev Ji, here you are, my name. Chaudhary is my courtesy title, like Mr. Chaudhary is not a part of my name. It is courtesy title. And Khatris are called Lala. In India, we have, you know, different tribes, different courtesy title. In the West, they have no concept of tribe. They don't know which tribe they are. So Rajendra Nijjar of Jat tribe, my tribe is Jat. First Gnostic principles of one God and one God, one faith. Whole book for your comments. So I put the whole book for your comments. I would appreciate it. It is in HTML. In HTML, my text moved this way or that way, you know. And some figure disappeared. Then I put in PDF. Then I give you one in doc, which you can alter and which you can play with. So hope you will join hands with me, and anything, because we're two or three are gathered together in the name of Christ Jesus, He is among us, because this is in Jesus we are royal priest. Royal priest, we give, we don't take out of the church. Priest is employed. Like in temple, they used to pay the priest, you know, but that corrupted priest. And these people in the dog-collar hireling in the churches, they are priests, and they are hireling of Mammon. They are paid by Mammon. They work for Mammon. As I told you a story of one David Patterson in Oxford, who is a retired vicar. And we were there in the debate on big question about God. And the presenter, Nicky Campbell, addressed him, Vicar David Patterson. Don't call me Vicar. I'm retired from my service. I'm no more Vicar. Don't address me. So they have to stop the program, restart it. So there were about 100 people sitting there. None of them came to know that this man, like a policeman with a dog collar around his neck, he was working for Mammon and not for God. He was a hypocrite. And what does he know about God? Nothing. And the one who know about God, they don't want to know it. I go to Oxford University, they don't like me. Because I ask them awkward question, which these men of dead letters, super donkeys carrying holy books, have no idea. So they get annoyed with me. So our Father God bless you, and watch. The time ahead is very, very harsh, because I passed through this time in 1947 when the partition of India took place, and 2,000 people of another tribe came to attack us, which were Mohammedan. But when my father told them that Sikh and Muslim, their spiritual self, never born, never die. So we tribal people going to fight with each other. If you have any enmity between tribe, let's settle it down. He said, we have no enmity, we are friends. And he so much was pleased that he asked my father, let's go to Lahore to stop this partition. But my father says, too late. So 2,000 people he brought to kill us. He told them, treat us like their guest or the apple of their eyes, and they did. They are good people, but the selfish people, the sons of the Satan, that Gandhi, Jinnah, and Tara Singh, they are all Lalas, sons of the most high Satan, kings of darkness. They bring this partition with the help of the hypocrite British, and the bloodshed is shared by the four of them, three Indian and one British, all share the bloodshed which happened during the partition. Our Father God bless you.